Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping you with the difference between strong electrolyte and weak electrolyte. So let's start. So if we talk about the strong electrolyte, then these are the compounds that directly dissociate in ions when dissolved in water. So when you mix the strong electrolyte in water, then they will completely turn into ions. Okay, that is the main property of strong electrolyte. But if we talk about the weak electrolyte, then these are the compounds that partially dissociate into ions when dissolved in water. So when you will mix the weak electrolyte in water, then they will partially dissociate, or we can say they will not release the complete ions when dissolved in water. Next thing, if we talk about the strong electrolyte, then they can highly conduct electricity through aqueous solution. Why so? Because they have large number of free ions present for carrying the electric charge. But if we talk about the weak electrolyte, then they can conduct electricity, but up to some extent through the aqueous solution. Why so? Because they have only a few number of ions present for conducting the electricity. Next thing, if we talk about the strong electrolyte, then these include strong acids, strong bases, and strong salts. Okay. But if we talk about the weak electrolyte, then weak acids, weak bases, and weak salts, or some salts are the example. Next thing, if we talk about the example, then strong electrolytes, the best example is seawater, which can highly conduct electricity. Okay, but if we talk about the weak electrolyte, then carbonic acid is a good example. So this was all about the difference between strong electrolyte and weak electrolyte. So if you like the video, please do hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.